Welcome into the Birmingham Southern Football Review. I'm Landrum Roberts. On this week's show, we'll recap the Panthers' road game at Hendricks College, sit down with head coach Eddie Garfinkel, have player interviews, game highlights, and our Panther top five plays of the game. All of that comes your way next, right here on the Birmingham Southern Football Review.
This is the BSC Football Review with head coach Eddie Garfinkel, an inside look at Birmingham Southern football.
The Birmingham Southern Football Review is being brought to you by Pepsi, always refreshing, Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers. If we don't take care of our customers, someone else will. Alabama Power, always on. America's First Federal Credit Union, refreshingly unbank-like. The Greater Birmingham Convention and Visitors Bureau. Dreamland Barbecue. Ain't nothing like them nowhere. Piggly Wiggly. We'll see you at the pig. Limbaugh Toyota. Home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. Southeast Urgent Care in Fultondale. Providing healthcare needs for BSE athletes. And by St. Vincent Sports Medicine. Performance medicine at its best.
My name's Nick Maxey, number 56. I play left guard. I'm from Leeds, Alabama, and graduated from Briarwood Christian High School. The three running backs we have are great. I'll start with the oldest, Jomo. He's a great leader, a good senior guy. Next in line, Samir Usman, number 7. He's a little bit bigger guy. He's a bruiser. Still quick and fast, though. And then Okorie is a new guy we picked up in the offseason. He's a good athlete, too. He's brought a new dimension to the run game. Coach White, our offensive coordinator, and Coach Hollifield, our offensive line coach, do a great job communicating and working with us. So Coach White has a great game plan set up for the week to run the ball, and Coach Hollifield really executes that through what he teaches us every day in drills and what we're working on and focusing on. So really gets us prepared for the game that we have that Saturday. Scoring in the red zone is a big deal. If you don't do that, you're not going to win any football games. But so far, we've made it a point of emphasis every practice to work on scoring in the red zone. And as an offensive lineman, it brings great pride and great admiration for our running backs that we can execute the blocks and they can execute their run and get it in the end zone. So that's a big part, and makes an offensive lineman really happy when he sees his running back running the end zone. But as far as making the decision, and for me, it was a good fit for me because I got the best of both worlds. I came to a football program where I knew they cared about me, that we were going to be successful and work hard and follow the same values that I had. And also in the schoolwork the same way. It's a great education to come out on top and have good connections through that education.
Welcome back to the Birmingham Southern Football Review. Landrum Roberts now being joined by Birmingham Southern head football coach Eddie Garfinkel and coach tough one in Conway, Arkansas on Saturday. Your conference foe, Hendricks College, went in there, played tough, but weren't able to come out with a victory.
Yeah, you know, that was a game that, you know, unfortunately this year we just can't put things together. And our offense came out and did a really good job, and we knew we had to run the football, keep our defense off the field, and then defense was kind of, a no-show, unfortunately. And, of course, that's my fault because I'm in charge of the defense also in the head and the whole team. So, you know, disappointing loss, but our guys played hard and worked hard all week, and I thought they were ready to play. We just couldn't get it done. And, of course, they had a really, really good offense, a really special quarterback. So it was a tough day.
It was really a lot like the games previous to this one. Your team really didn't struggle in the first half. It was right there, 24-17. Hendricks led going into intermission. You get the first quarter touchdown with Joe Moultrie going into the end zone.
Yeah, you know, again, we felt like our offense could do some things running the football, and that was our goal. And with Mickey Courtney, freshman quarterback, going in, we really simplified our passing game and gave him opportunities to be successful in short control passes, and it worked. And then defensively, you know, unfortunately, you know, we missed a lot of tackles and just didn't play to our potential. And so, you know, it's just a deal where, you know, we just got to get better defensively, and should have never been in that situation, but we were, unfortunately, you know, chasing points, and we just got to do better.
Nice to see the development of the freshman Mickey Courtney out of El Paso, Texas, and his growth in the maturation process in your offense this week. He was 17 of 26, no interceptions, threw for 203 yards and a couple touchdowns. He looked pretty good on Saturday.
Yeah, Mickey's going to be a really good quarterback. Of course, we've got to really, you know, be careful about what we do and ask him to do. We can't ask him to make a lot of decisions and you know, win the game for us. And he did a good job. Coach White and the staff did a really good job. And so, you know, again, we just got to put together special team-wise, defense and offense. And we feel like, you know, we're not far away. So if we feel like we do that, we've got a shot.
It was telling just looking in the box score and looking at the game stats. Your club throws for 203 yards, runs for 230, so balanced offensively, no turnovers, and you held the ball for 28 minutes and 30 seconds on offense.
Right. You know, again, possession time is one thing that we're really trying to work on, because defensively, when we're on the field a lot, we're not real good, and we get tired. Of course, we weren't real good the entire game this time, and for whatever reason, we had 20-plus missed tackles that cost us a lot of points and yardage. And so, but you know, that's the way we're going to be able to win football games, is offense keeping the ball and running the football and not turn the ball over. And defensively, we got to do better getting the ball to our offense and keep them out of the end zone.
Well, you mentioned last week on the show, and you weren't lying, talking about their quarterback from Hendricks probably being one of the best that you would face all season. Thank goodness for Birmingham Southern. He was amazing on Saturday, 36 of 44, 451 yards through the air. He gave you fits all day.
Yeah, he did. We tried to do everything. We tried rushing three people, four people, five people, six people, and mixing coverages, and just couldn't get off the field on third down. And he was really good. And so they do a really good job on offense. I mean, they've Coach Buchanan, they've got everybody back from last year, and their offensive line, they're big guys, and they've got good receivers, got a really good scheme, so they're difficult to stop. So it was quite a challenge, and unfortunately we didn't, you know, rise to the occasion defensively.
You trailed 24-17 going into the half, and then really, I thought early in the third quarter, that really was the tail of the game. When they came out, they got the quick touchdown, and then the onside kick, that was really the dagger.
Right, and that's one thing that we talk to our players about, we work on, is we have to set the tone. You know, the ball game, the first 5 minutes of the game, and the first 5 minutes of the second half, and we didn't, especially with the onside kick. There was a great execution by their kicker and their kickoff team, and they had a little pooch kick that landed. They caught it in the air, and so again, you know, that momentum really gave them a shot in the arm. But to our players' credit, you know, we never kind of gave in and just never could fight our way back.
Coach, the main areas that you've addressed with your team, your coaching staff, that you need to improve on?
You know, basically, we've got to be able to play together as a team. You know, we can't go out in one game and have our defense, be productive and do some good things, and our offense not there. And then same thing, the opposite that happened this past week. Our special teams have got to really, really improve, and we've got to be consistent and have an edge in the special teams. And then the fourth quarter, you know, we've got to finish ball games, and we got to find a way to win when the game is close in the fourth quarter. So that's the main focus for us right now.
Coach, getting off to a rough start, a start that you didn't anticipate, you didn't want, no one did. What's the message to your team, and how are they responding from what you can tell?
Well, you know, the message is, look, you know, now is when our true character comes out, you know, and we you know, the mission of our program is to develop young men into mature adults and teach life lessons. And this is a life lesson, you know. Bad things are going to happen in life, and it's just how you react to those things and how you accept those challenges. And 0-4 start, I hope that's the worst thing that ever happens to our guys in their life, you know, and hopefully we'll respond in the right way and find a way to beat Swanee this week.
All right, speaking of Swanee, When we come back, we'll look ahead to Homecoming 2014 here on the Hilltop, as well as feature our Panther top five plays of the game. All of that comes your way next as the Birmingham Southern Football Review continues right after this.
All right, come on in. You'll try the Pepsi Challenge with us today?
Yes. You just tell us which side you like better.
Okay. I like that one better.
You like that side better? The Pepsi side.
Who wants to start a Pepsi Challenge? Come on over. You like this side better?
That is a Pepsi. Pepsi.
And you're from Atlanta?
I'm from Atlanta.
You're going to go home and spread the word that...
You're going to go home and hot. Pepsi tastes better.
At Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers, we believe in service.
Maintenance service, tire service, repair service.
And most importantly, customer service.
We believe in treating our customers with respect and integrity while offering all the services you need for your car.
Most of all, at Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers,
we believe in keeping cars on the road, keeping families safe,
and keeping you coming back whenever the need arises.
This is big. Limbaugh Toyota's big time savings event. $17,888 buys Camry. Yes, Camry. Now $17,888 automatic, no charge. Big time savings now at Limbaugh Toyota. Camry, only $17,888 automatic, no charge. Don't wait. Savings this big won't last long at Limbaugh Toyota. Exit 120 off I-59 West.
We supply over 44,000 square miles of Alabama with electricity every day. We're there no matter what, because our state needs us. And more importantly, you need us. We're dedicated to keeping your power flowing even in the face of extreme weather or even more extreme federal mandates. Dedication. That's how we bring power to Alabama. Alabama Power. Always on.
Joe Moultrie. Senior running back, number 20 here at Birmingham Southern, and I graduated from Huffman High School. September 21st, 2013, suffered a season-ending injury that at the time I really didn't know why. A lot of whys and how comes, but I knew it was a reason for it. It's a reason for everything, in my opinion. Man, the biggest thing that I hold dear to me, especially playing football, is my teammates, and I knew that they needed me throughout the rest of the season that year. So I stayed around, rehab, still showed up to games, came to practices when I could, when the pain wasn't too bad, and just still being that constant leader that I could be. Upon the season ending, Coach called me in the office and said it was a possibility that I could get a fifth year medical red shirt. And at first, you know, I wasn't too sure with, you know, graduation right around the corner and the key goal for Birmingham Southern is to finish in 4 years and get that degree so I can, you know, enter into the workforce. But it was just something just eating at me, you know, in the back of my mind, just telling me that, you know, you can't end your career like that. So a lot of praying and a lot of talking with my family, we decided that it'll be a good thing that I come back and come through this year. But my first goal was to know for sure that my leg was 100%. I told Coach that was a big thing for me. The only way I'd come back is if I was comfortable on my knee and I wasn't hesitant at all. So a lot of rehab, a lot of restless nights, a lot of hard days, but I put in the work and the product is showing up on Saturdays this season. So kind of a duo threat at quarterback. We have Austin Martin, who's a sophomore who started off the year for us. Real good runner, real good passer. And then we had the freshman, Mickey, who was kind of knocking at Austin Hills after the second week. And now going into Sewanee this week, Mickey is starring for us. The biggest thing with Mickey is keeping him grounded. I mean, he's young, he's a freshman quarterback. And although we played Division III football, it's still another level, still a step up from high school. So the biggest thing that I try and tell Mickey all the time is that we believe in him, which we do, and we're confident in him, which we are. And as long as he know that, and he keep doing what he does, I feel like he can definitely lead our team to the goals that we got to achieve And in saying that, a big thing that as an offense we try and do just to keep Mickey settled is run the ball to set up the pass. So it's more easy on him than making the reads that the defense had to come up and honor the run, which we've been doing a good job of this year. Well, this week, I went into this game with a real want to. Going in down, you know, the record being down on us, I had to let my team know that at any cost, I would not be giving up on this week. And that's what I took into the game. I mean, and looking at the film, you can see I was running with relentless and passion, because this past week, we worked our butts off going through the game plan, practicing, giving each other looks, and I would not let it boil down to whether I was not doing my part or not. And the two touchdown runs, I seen the goal line, and that's what my mind was set on. I was gonna get in the goal, get in the end zone, and I managed to do it. Birmingham Southern has molded me into a well-rounded individual. I can say that for the most part. When I first came here, I was not as mature as I am now. I didn't hold dear the mores and the values that I have now. But going through the, not only football, but going through the curriculum that we have here, I've learned to be disciplined. I've learned to work hard. I've learned to ask for help. Just the little things that I used to take granted day by day coming out of high school, Birmingham Southern has shown me why they are important in life. So, that's what Birmingham Southern has done for me, helped me grow into a man, in a sense. So.
Welcome back to the Birmingham Southern Football Review. Landrum Roberts once again being joined by BSC head football coach Eddie Garfinkel. And now it's time for our Panther top five plays of the game. Our number five play was freshman quarterback Mickey Courtney finding Sam Vermilier down the sideline.
Yeah, that was a really good throw and catch by Mickey. We had trips and had single coverage on Sam, and Mickey threw it up there and did a really good job.
Our number four play of the game was once again freshman Mickey Courtney finding Michael Cowan down the sideline as Cowan went up and grabbed this reception.
You know, one of the things that we try to do, you know, people try to, you know, really gang up on the running game, and we'll throw, you know, some three steps and stuff. And actually, Michael kind of had double coverage and really did a good job of going up and grabbing the ball between the corner of the safety. So great play by Michael at a crucial time.
Our number three play of the game was senior Joe Moultrie finding the end zone from 3 yards out.
Yeah, you know, that's one of the things that we you know, really stress and work on, and have not had a whole lot of success is getting the ball in the end zone. So the first time down there, we had our big personnel in, and the offensive line did a good job, and Joe did a great job of fighting for second effort and getting the ball across the goal line.
Our number two Panther play of the game was Mickey Courtney finding Michael Cowan for this Panther touchdown.
You know, we were down there earlier in that same personnel, and they were playing man coverage, inside leverage, and Mickey did a really good job, just a quick out route, and really put the ball in the money, and good throw and catch by Mickey and Michael.
And our number one Panther play of the game was the defense's goal line stand and holding Hendricks to a field goal before the half.
You know, that was one thing that was big for us. You know, we let him down there off of a big play before the half, and we made him kick a field goal, and that's something that we've worked hard on, trying to, you know, keep guys out of the end zone and make them sell for field goals. And the last play, especially on third down, was our players did a really good job. We had a check according to their formation. They checked it right into the proper formation, and as far as the proper defense, they were able to make the play.
So that's this week's Panther top five plays of the game. All right, Coach, homecoming 2014 here on the Hilltop this Saturday. Familiar opponent coming down from Tennessee in the Suwannee Tigers. Talk about Suwannee, unorthodox, old school offense that your defense will be challenged to face.
Yeah, they run the wishbone, and, you know, Coach Lauren Dean has done a great job, and they've had our number. You know, they're the only team that's beat us the last 2 years in a row. It's going to be quite a challenge. And, you know, we're going to have to offensively, you know, control the football, keep our defense off the field. And then defensively, you know, we're going to have to, you know, get the ball back to our offense. I don't think they've lined up in a punt formation this year. And they, when they do punt, you know, they do a quick kick with their quarterback. So they're going to go for it on fourth down. It's going to be quite a challenge. And so we're going to have to really play well on all phases of the game. That was one thing last year that they really had the edge in the kicking game. So we're gonna have to really be the top of our game to have a chance to beat Swanee this week.
Coach, how tough will it be to keep your team's focus this week with homecoming taking place here on campus?
I hope it's not going to be too difficult. You know, homecoming, you know, since they started football back, has been a big thing here on campus, and a lot of the alumni and former players will be back, and so. You know, I'm hoping our guys can understand that they're part of the homecoming festivity is winning the football game. And I think we're hungry enough, and I think we got a mature enough team to really focus on one thing, and that's find a way to beat Swanee this Saturday.
All right, kickoff set for 1 o'clock right here at Panther Stadium. Make your plans to be here. Well, when we come back, much more to come. The BSC Football Review continues right after this.
Southeast Urgent Care, located in Fultondale, Alabama, is owned and operated by former BSC baseball player and alumnus Dr. Paul Roberts. Dr. Roberts is board certified in emergency medicine and has over 10 years' experience in the busiest emergency rooms in Alabama. Dr. Roberts and his staff are able to provide high-quality medical care in a state-of-the-art facility with digital x-ray and on-site lab testing. Southeast Urgent Care is able to provide the care you want at the time you need and with a friendly attitude that will make you feel like you're not just another patient.
With the new mobile deposit feature through the America's First Banking app, depositing a check is easier than posting a latte pic. Just photograph the check, confirm the amount, and send. Best of all, mobile deposit is free at America's First Federal Credit Union.
Welcome back to the Birmingham Southern Football Review. Well, now it's time to honor our Birmingham Southern Scholar Athlete of the Week.
Hi, I'm Zach Perkins. I am a senior right guard, number 60 for the Birmingham Southern Panthers. I am from Grant, Alabama, and I went to KDS DRR High School. So I see the offensive line helping the team, you know, find their way to success, putting things in the win column, just continuing playing physical, with the physical nature, and asserting dominance over the people when we step in between the white lines. It's really easy to block for our running backs because they're so fast, big, strong. You know, in high school, you're sitting there and you're blocking. But now, especially at this level and the running backs that we have, it's quick, get in their way, and you just watch Jomo run to the touchdown. And it's so quick, agile, move back and forth very quickly. If I was a student looking to come to BSC, I would come knowing that this place is not easy. But you're not expecting it to be easy. You expect you to come to work hard and get the degree that gives you the name recognition of being a graduate from Birmingham Southern College. But with that, it's possible. Everybody's here to help you. You're always going to find somebody wanting to help you, pat you on the back, you know, give you the little secret, the little tips. And everything's possible. You just have to trust others.
And that was this week's Birmingham Southern Scholar Athlete of the Week.
Back in 1958, Big Daddy John Bishop opened Dreamland Barbecue with his signature recipe for sauce and hickory fire grilled ribs. And that legendary taste and recipe have remained unchanged for over half a century. Dreamland now serves everything from ribs to pulled pork and chicken to sausage links and still uses that famous sauce. Come in as customers and leave as family at Dreamland. Ain't nothing like them nowhere.
All right, come on in. You're trying the Pepsi Challenge with us today?
Yes.
You just tell us which side you like better.
Okay. I like that one better.
You like that side better. Now Pepsi side.
Who wants a side of Pepsi challenge? Come on over. Do you like this side better?
That is a Pepsi.
And you're from Atlanta?
I'm from Atlanta.
You're gonna go home and spread the word that.
You're gonna go home and hide. Pepsi tasted better.
Well, that's going to do it for this week's edition of the Birmingham Southern Football Review. On Saturday, it's homecoming 2014 here on the Hilltop. Kickoff is set for 1 o'clock as the Panthers host Swanee. For all of us here at Birmingham Southern College, our president, General Charles Krulak, our athletic director, Joe Dean Jr., and sports information director, Sarah Recca, I'm Landrum Roberts. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week. The Birmingham Southern Football Review is being brought to you by Pepsi, always refreshing. Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers. If we don't take care of our customers, someone else will. Alabama Power, always on. America's First Federal Credit Union, refreshingly unbanked life. The Greater Birmingham Convention and Visitors Bureau. Dreamland Barbecue. Ain't nothing like them nowhere. Piggly Wiggly. We'll see you at the pig. Limbaugh Toyota. Home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. Southeast Urgent Care in Fultondale. Providing healthcare needs for BSE athletes. And by St. Vincent Sports Medicine. Performance medicine at its best.